Once you have concluded data collection, you can start analyzing data and interpret them to build up a discussion on your findings. About data analysis, you should note that one of the main benefits of qualitative methodologies compared to quantitative ones is you can do farther data collection at any time. So, once you believe you have concluded the data collection process, you can start analyzing data to possibly expand your data gathering later when needed. Data analysis can be performed by following these steps. Make a summary of the data you have collected, analyze interviews, triangulate with other data, and interpret the findings. For instance, the table from Clark and colleagues shows how the summary should include all sources of data. The way the summary is structured strongly depends on the method chosen and the type of analysis performed. In this table, the summary includes all sources and the data is structured by source type. As we know, the primary source of data for case studies are interviews. Once an interview has been transcribed, you can start analyzing its text. The text analysis process consists in the content analysis, which is performed through the so-called coding. The purpose of coding is to identify patterns, relations, and theory. Concerning coding, Strauss and Corbing, 1998, define it as the analytic process of examining data line by line or paragraph by paragraph, whatever is your style, for significant events, experiences, feelings, and so on, that are then denoted as concepts. A code is a label, a concept, a word that signifies what is going on in this piece of data. Through coding, we label any important information in the text we are analyzing. Labels can be decided by the analyzer or can be taken from the content too. There are several types of codes you can use. First, in vivo codes, called this way in Glaser and Strauss' 1967 work on grounded theory. These codes are the very words that participants use in the interview. Second, constructed codes that are built or constructed by the analyzer. They could be the same of in vivo codes, or they could be conceptual ideas, or even terms coming from academic theories. This table from Taylor and Gibbs illustrates examples of constructs that can be coded starting from interviews content. To better understand how the coding process for an interview analysis unravels, we can picture how it changes with reference to a deductive or inductive approach the researcher can take in designing her or his study. A deductive approach to the case study and its coding, which suits well an explanatory case study, starts from defining a research question and the theory-based elements of the study. Theory hence serves to define the categories and codes to be used for data coding so that the interpretation of the result will be made in the light of the theory deductively selected. Such approach also influences the sequence found in the coding tree, where the theory-derived variables and categories are supported by empirical evidences, the codes. Inductive coding, on the contrary, still starts from a broadly defined research question, as it happens in exploratory cases, but is more open about how the empirical data and information collected can shape the theoretical implications. This is why such approach is also called open coding. Here, the researcher starts from the text and labels are not predetermined from theory, but stem from text analysis. Homogeneous codes are hence grouped so as to define growingly abstract categories, which in turn will be interpreted in the light of existing theories. These theories may be similar to the ones that drove the definition of the original research questions, but may even depart from them. The resulting inductive coding tree shows how we move from a particular and real-world code to general and abstract theories, thus making for theory building.